Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Master Sergeant Sam Woodhead. I'm the chairman of the American Trombone Workshop, and it's my pleasure to welcome you again back in person to the American Trombone Workshop. It's somewhat fitting that the last time we met in person, our featured soloist with a concert band on the last piece of the program is now our next guest. Peter Steiner is an amazing performer, and he's been gracious enough, he stepped in at the last minute to run our group warm-up session this morning, so I hope a lot of you were able to take advantage of coming to that. He's been here in the United States touring. This is his second tour this year, and he's been here for 8 weeks with Constanza, touring to all parts of the country. And when I saw that he was going to be in the United States again, I immediately asked him if he would be willing to join us again and come here. So we were fortunate to have him solo with the Washington Trombone Ensemble last night. That video is up on YouTube, and you can watch it if you weren't able to see it in person. So it's great. It's up there for all time now. and just like this recital, so definitely want to welcome our audience that are watching via the live stream. I remind you that those of you in attendance, you'll be able to watch it also on the YouTube channel. So please make sure to look for that. Later today, we do have a masterclass with Jeremy Wilson in this same space at 5:30, and then an amazing concert with the U.S. Army Blues in the Lobota Studio across the way at 7:30, featuring Vincent Gardner from the Kennedy Center Jazz Orchestra. That'll be a fantastic concert. And don't forget to come back here tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock for another group warm-up session. So, as I mentioned, we had Peter last night, and he was with us in 2020, right before the pandemic hit. And so it's with great pleasure that I welcome back to the stage Peter Steiner and Constanza Hochwartner.
Thank you. And be playing for you here today. We opened our concert with a little crazy piece by the Swiss composer Bertrand Morin. He originally intended this piece for bass trombone and piano, and then later realized that it sounds much better on a tenor trombone, so he adapted it for tenor trombone. So we really, really hope you enjoyed this piece entitled Psychedelia. The next piece that we're going to play for you, especially for all the trombonists in the room, which I assume most of you are, I don't really have to introduce this piece, but maybe at home somebody on the YouTube screen is not a trombonist, so I'll introduce it still. It's one of our biggest standards in the literature, if not the biggest standard. We actually have to play it all the time when growing up. It also probably comes here at the ATW competitions quite often. It happens that this piece has to be performed. This happened to me growing up. I kind of had to face this piece often with different teachers and with different competitions and auditions. So you develop your passages and you just kind of develop some hate towards a piece. Let's just be honest, with a lot of repetition there, it's just a little bit of that as well in there. And then when Constanze and I met and she heard this piece for the very first time after the performance of that duo that was performing back then, she came up to me and she said, "Peter, please, let's play this piece. It's such a wonderful piece." And I looked at her completely shocked out of her mind and I was like, no. It was a very, very fast conversation and I didn't even, you know, bother thinking about it twice. A couple of weeks later, she comes up to me again and she says, well, I gave this a little bit more thought and, you know, lyricism in this piece. I think, you know, this really fits our next program really, really well. And I again looked at her and I was like, no, 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 please stop thinking about this. And I thought that would be the end of the conversation. I was very, very happy with that end. And I was happy to move on and just discuss some different repertoire that we could play together. Well, then the pandemic happened and we were kind of locked down in quite heavy restrictions in Austria. And one day I'm practicing in my practice room and I hear from the other side of the apartment, I hear this, the beginning of this piece, and I'm just like, oh, you know, it's like shivers going through my body. And I'm like, oh, okay, it's actually happening. She's going for it. And I was like, well, I guess if she started to pull out the music already and she's working on it, I guess I just have to go with the flow now. And I'm glad I did. I fell in love with the piece again. I think there's a reason why it's the biggest standard in our literature. It's a beautiful work, and we probably just do it way too often as trombonists, probably way too early. We want to play it and touch it and work on it. And then the other thing is, every time you perform this as a trombonist, you just get a 4-bar introduction of the piano, which is kind of a reduction of like a minute and a half that we take out the most beautiful part of the piece, which, you know, kind of makes the piece also not so much enjoyable when you play it as a trombonist growing up. But today I have the luxury to play this together with Constanze. Very interesting story about this piece. It was actually supposed to be composed by a completely different composer. It was the commission actually received Felix Mendelssohn Bartholdy, and when he received this, he was not really too intrigued about the trombone being a solo instrument, and he declined, and he asked his good friend, Mr. Ferdinand David, to compose the piece instead of him, and he then sat down and composed this concertino in 3 movements. And pretty interesting story, or funny actually, when you go on Google and you type in Ferdinand David, the first thing that comes up is his trombone concertino. So I guess we are keeping him alive. Let's think of it that way. Really, really hope you enjoy our version of this piece, Ferdinand David Concertino. I'm
And we were really shocked because the Ukraine is so close to our home. It's just a couple hours of driving and then we're there. And I think nobody can imagine the pain that the people are going through over there. So we thought it might be nice to show some sympathy with including a piece by a Ukrainian composer into our repertoire. And so I started to do some research and I came across Mykola Lysenko, and he wrote this elegy for violin and piano, and we adapted it for the two of us, so we really hope you enjoy this beautiful piece.
Thank you.
instrument is actually the cello. That's why I'm always trying to force Peter to play some beautiful cello and piano music with me. And I made it happen. We are now going to play a piece composed by Niccolo Paganini. It's called Moses Variations on a Theme. It starts with the introduction of the theme. That's a slow introduction, then a couple of crazy variations and the grande finale. So we really hope you enjoy this fun piece.
Thank you.
To play this next piece by our dear friend Mr. Nitzan Haroz, and we were touring the US before the pandemic, and when we were touring through Texas, and Texas means a lot of driving through the state. So we were listening to his recording of this piece and we fell in love with it, and so we decided to also record this piece on our most recent album 2022, and we're now going to play it for you. It's composed by Jan Freidlin and it's called Towards the Light. It's a little bit more jazzy, so we really hope you like it.
This piece is also the last piece that we're going to play for you today. And before we play this piece, I would like to thank the person in charge for having us and hosting us here today. As Sam said before when he introduced us, we were actually here last time when the workshop was in person, and then already then we started to talk about future collaboration, and we started to look about, you know, into 2023, and then everything kind of just lined up, and now we're here performing for you, and we really, really hope you enjoyed the last 45 minutes together with us. So please, let's give a big round of applause for Sam Goodhead for organizing all of this. And then we would like to thank all of you. Without you, the hall would have been empty and we would have not been nervous. Mm-hmm. So thank you very much. Thanks so much for doing that to us. And there's just so many familiar faces in the room today. I'm sure there's also many of them watching right now. We have been touring extensively here throughout the States for the past 5 months, actually. It's been very, very, very long, but also very short. It feels very short. The last couple of weeks we have already been counting down the days until we have to leave. So it's kind of sad to be leaving the States tomorrow, and you are our last audience from about, I don't know, 50 or 60 concerts or so in the last 5 months. And it's been super fun to be with all of you. There's so many hosts sitting here and just around the building, so many people that hosted us over the past couple months. And we just want to thank all of you. Without you liking and enjoying what we are doing, we would not be doing this and traveling the world. So really, really thanks so much for all of your support and for enjoying what we do. That really, really means a lot to both of us. And then lastly, I want to thank Constanze. She has been suffering with me through rental cars, fighting on who can have the nicer seat on a flight, debating whether it will be Five Guys or Chipotle on that lunch day. She has been suffering through all of this, and I know we are duo, so we don't really usually thank each other and introduce each other, but please, a big round of applause for Constanze. And then lastly, as Constanze pointed out already, we have been pretty productive during the pandemic. We used the time wisely to make some check marks after some projects that we always wanted to make happen. And so we thought it would be a very, very smart idea to record a Christmas album. Both of us really enjoy the Christmas time. And every time that time of the year comes around, we always fantasized, maybe one day there will be a Christmas album of the two of us. Trombone and piano, or trombone and organ. So during the pandemic, we thought now it's perfect time to do this. And as you might all know, is whenever you release a CD or when you record a CD, you can't just record it and then you release it within a week or so. Unfortunately, the process is much, much longer and time-consuming. So we found ourselves in May and June recording Silent Night, Carol of the Bells, and all these carols. So that was a very, very interesting experience on top of doing all of this in our apartment. So our neighbors probably thought we were a little off, but you know, they probably think that already anyways. So we recorded a Christmas CD, and that was is entitled The First Noel, is that one here. And then all of the program that you heard today is then recorded on the album 2022. We thought when the world opened up again to record a new repertoire and then tour the world with this, and we really hope you enjoyed this program today that we played for you. If you enjoy our music making and you want to take us with you home, or you want to simply just get a CD with a nice picture on the front and a signature on top of there, and maybe also a heart, yes, Constanze can draw a heart for you on there, please come up afterwards and get your CD. We'll be selling them out there, and look forward to chatting with all of you. Really hope you enjoy this last piece, Towards the Light by Jan Freidlin. Thank you. because it's been so much fun, we'll keep going. The last piece that we'll play for you, what do we play for them now? The last piece we'll play for you, we tend to steal a lot of music from other great composers, as you already seen throughout the concert today. And just because simply not too many composers have thought of this combination when they were starting to compose this piece. But I'm sure the next composer, he would have thought about trombone and piano. We really hope you enjoy the Hungarian Dance by Johannes Brahms. Thank you.